With me in the studio, Canada's 20th Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Jean Chretien. Mr. Chretien, you're 81 years old, you're out campaigning like you were 30. Why were you working so hard for Justin Trudeau?
Because they asked me, and that it was, you have to understand that I had a special relation with the Prime Minister elected. I was sitting next to his father in the House of Commons, and we were talking about kids and so on, and the progress in their lives. And when he came into politics, he consulted with me, and you remember, I'm probably not the only one who told him that, but I said, don't run in your dad's riding. Do it on your own. And he went in a very tough riding, where he defeated a very good Liberal candidate that had been running the previous time with opposition. And he defeated the vice president of the Parti Québécois in that riding. And he won it. So he worked, you know, he's way up. And now he's at the top. And I wish him the best of luck.
You're one of the few people alive, left, who was in Pierre Trudeau's cabinet. What was it like working for Mr. Trudeau?
He was a very good guy to work with. Anyway, with me anyway. He was very nice, he was not pushy, and he let you do your own work. And I remember one time he called me and he said, Jean, you have not talked to me since a year. Are you mad at me? I said, no, Prime Minister. I said, I'm not calling you because I don't want to disturb you. And you're not calling me. I'm quite happy that you don't have to talk to me. So I'm worried with this phone call. And he just said, it's because, you know, if they were all like you, Jean, it would be so easy to be Prime Minister.
So what qualities do you see in Justin Trudeau that are familiar to his father?
But he is a serious young man, and he can have very serious discussions. But something that I said during the campaign that nobody knew, and he said that in his speech in Vancouver the night before the election, if genes are coming into the body of somebody in politics, I got it from my grandfather, Sinclair. Jimmy Sinclair was quite a politician. And he was Minister of Fisheries very young for Louis Saint-Laurent. And that he was a coming man, but he was taken out in the sweep of Diefenbaker in 1958. And he went in the private sector. But he was quite a personality. He was a tall guy, good-looking, comfortable with people.
So you supported Mr. Trudeau's decision to pull out of the air war in Iraq and Syria. Do you think that will worry our allies at all?
I don't know. I think that, you know, we had a position that was easy to defend, that we were moving under the flag of the UN or NATO. That was the policy. That was a policy that existed under Trudeau. When we had the first war in Iraq, you know, Maroney waited to have the advice of the UN before moving up. And it was my policy too. And that's why I said no to the war in Iraq to George W. Bush. And, you know, just to be there, being the 51st wheel. And we're there under the umbrella of the Americans. You know, I'm of the view that if they had asked the Russians and the Chinese to be in that mission, they might have wanted to be there. Now, the Russians are there on the ground.
What about dealing then with Putin? You know, Mr. Harper was very hard on him. He's, you know, get out of Ukraine. I mean, yeah. How should the new
prime... But do you think that Putin did not sleep at all that night? You know, I know him. I went to talk with him. I wanted to have the two sides of the coin. And we Canadians, we were good at that. And we were accepted by everybody at that. Trying, you know, Mr. Trudeau could talk to anybody because he kept his independence and he was looking elsewhere. You remember, the Americans did not like the fact that he was friendly with Fidel Castro. You remember that? So, but it might have been useful with other people that he could keep doors open like that.
So your advice to Mr. Trudeau
is... Talk to everybody and try to offer a solution.
And what about Iran? Should we reopen our embassy there like Great Britain has done?
Why not? What, is it useful, you know, that we don't talk to people? I believe in dialogue. I'm talking with you. You attack me half of your lifetime, and I'm still talking with you. So, you know, I always talk with everybody, and I learned that way. But just to, you know, I would tell him, fine, but, you know, I know these guys. Canada is a big country, but we're a bit not the biggest, you know. So it's like, you know, give us a pipeline or else.
So what would your advice be to Mr. Trudeau in dealing with the Americans?
The difficulty, it's easy to have good relations with the President of the United States. I have very good relations with Bill Clinton, everybody knows that. And with George W. on a personal basis, because he was an easy guy to deal with. He has his position, it did not discuss. So I would say white, he would say black, fine, let's talk baseball now. So, you know, it was easy. And I have very good relation with him personally. But the difficulty with the President of the United States is he cannot deliver as a prime minister can deliver. Because he has always to go to the Congress or to the Senate. And, you know, he would say, I'd like to do that, but I'm blocked there and I'm blocked there. It is a very complex situation in America. And you have to understand the difficulty that a president has to deliver on his policies. And you talk with the president, a prime minister of Canada, he can deliver, because otherwise, if you lose a vote in the House of Commons, it's an election. Same thing in Great Britain. The French president has a lot of authority. But the President of the United States has great moral authority. But on daily business of every file, it's extremely frustrating for a president.
So you've lived in 24 Sussex. It's an old place. Everybody says it should be fixed up. Should Trudeau say, look, I'm not moving in. Let's get this place fixed up for the next prime minister?
It is an occasion, in my judgment, to look at all of that. I reflected on that. Because, you know, now the Parliament Hill will be closing down very soon. So there will be a rearrangement of offices, and perhaps they should think about having what to do with the operation of a prime minister, who operate, in fact, in three places. He operate on the Hill, he operate on the Langevin Block, and he operate at 24 Sussex, and sometime Harrington Lake. So, you know, they should reflect on that. And to have a solution that would make the life of the prime minister easy and his security easier to handle and all that jazz. I lived there, and I was going to 24 Sussex during the time of his father when he was living there and so on. And in fact, the difficulty we have in Canada, when you spend $1 on the house, the press write that the prime minister spent money as if it was for the fun. For me, I was there. And it was raining in the house. And I would not accept not to be accused of spending the taxpayer money. I said, when it will be raining enough, well, I will call the press and show them the bucket to pick up the water. I was lucky. The high storm took off the roof so they could make a new roof. God was on my side.
So you really think this place needs to be fixed? Okay.
I was there with my wife, you know, and we had to put in the bedroom electric heater. You know, and bang, the electricity will go in the middle of the night because it was too much. I was there with poor Al Gore one day, having a difficult fight with a fight between Al Gore and Brian Tobin, and I was there in the middle in July. He had his vest plus his coat, and I had in the window a little machine, you know, that you turn with your hand. That was the air conditioning of the Prime Minister of Canada. So it's about time to be reasonable about that. It is not for him, it is for the state, and we receive people there, and if they can fix the problem, you know, we will look better. Because, you know, we're not, you know, it's not very nice when you look like a bunch of cheap guys.
Mr. Chretien, thank you very much, and I'm assuming 4 years from now you'll still be out campaigning for Justin Trudeau.
I have to tell you, I enjoy it. I went in six provinces and to meet with the crowds and have fun, and it was very pleasant, you know. Justin asked me to say thank you to Aline, and I said for letting me do that. And I said, Justin, I have to tell you, she didn't have to push me very hard.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Appreciate it.